for a generation that's grown up only reading about dangerous gangsters and the eventual police crackdown on them, the one name that obviously stands out is Daud Ibrahim. And not just him, in fact, many of his siblings too have some point or the other been investigated by the police for their connections with some criminal activity. But to understand an insight into these personas, we have with us Mr. Hussain Zaidi, who's an author and a former journalist. Thank you for joining us, sir. We see a lot of these projections, romanticized gangsters in Bollywood movies, but how much of that is actually true when you interact with them in person?
On-screen image is always the magnification or the amplified visual of the real persona. I mean, what happens is when they cast a star, they have to ensure that they pander to the ego of the star and they have to glorify him. So even if the real character does not have those positive traits or those, you know, redeeming features, they will ensure that the person on the screen has those things. I think the movies need to work on the projection of the gangsters.
Now, about Daud as well as his brothers, we've seen so much that's been on the public, in the media as well as in the public platform. But Haseena Parker is one person, there's not much that's been written about her, because she's not been in the spotlight. So I remember you had in fact met her for your research for Dongi to Dubai also. So how did that go? How did you prepare yourself?
Haseena and I had kind of developed a bond where she knew that I know her brother, I know Mumbai crime scene, and I'm also aware about where she stands in the entire crime graph. When I was researching on my book on the Mafia Queens of Mumbai, and I had met a lot of people like Asha Gavli, Gavli's wife, and I had met Neeta Naik, Haseena was one of my subjects, so I had to meet her and I had to look at her whether she also fits the bill of being the crime queen or Mafia Queen of Mumbai. So when I met her, I realized that Mumbai police hardly has any cases against her. There's barely one threat case and one small NC. So that she cannot be the Mafia Queen. Just because she was Daud's sister doesn't make her a bad woman or a very evil woman. What I found very strange about her was that she was a grieving widow despite 20 years after the death of her husband. She was very scared that someday people should not single out her son Danish or her other children. Now Haseena Parker was one such person where she is very enigmatic. She is kind of inscrutable. People wanted to believe that she is using her brother's connection, but they were still not sure whether that's true or not. I had to decode this the puzzle about the perception behind Haseena's personality.
What was her reaction when you asked these tough questions?
Well, at times she was very upset with me. She said, "Ke, aap mujhse is tarah se baat mat kijiye, mujhse aise koi baat nahi karta." So I said, "Well, I mean, mujhe aapse koi dushmani nahi hai. Main aapse koi shikayat nahi rakhta. Lekin main chahta hu ki aap sach bataye taki I can project that with absolute honesty in my book." So then she kind of opened up and she understood that I don't have any malicious intention to defame the family. I mean well and I want to write things with absolute clarity and with right intentions in my book. So she opened up and we spoke a lot. Then she started consulting me that what I should be doing. There are so many cases that cops are slapping against me. My phone is constantly on the tab. I said, "Tell me, are you talking to your brother regularly on phone?" She said, "No, I don't talk to my brother regularly." So then I asked her that, "Do you greet each other on Eid and on those festive occasions?" She just looked at me and said, "What do you want to answer?" I said, "No, I want an honest answer." She said, "If I say that yes, we do greet on Eid occasions, then cops will start tapping my phone more. If I said I don't, then there will be another kind of queries and curiosity around that question. It's better I keep quiet."
When you're doing these sort of stories, which you know it could create a controversy, and you know staying objective is the key in this case, but when you meet such strong personalities, do they often, you know, it's the emotion, I mean, they do in fact bring out an emotion. So how do you deal with that?
In my research, I have always found that gangsters were never the victim of circumstances, as they would like people to believe. That mujhe majboori se apradhi banna pada, ya mujhe police ne apradhi bana diya. Taking to crime is a matter of choice. It's so much like terrorism. I mean, you become terrorist because you want to become terrorist. You want to terrorize people. Similarly, people become criminal because they want to commit crime or they want to have some kind of clout and some kind of hold in the society. Haseena, I think, got thrown into the limelight because of her relationship with her brother, Daud. And she had no qualms in admitting that among all her six brothers, Daud was her dearest brother.
From what you've seen of Daud's siblings, they've always been overshadowed by his image. So do you think they got into it because of their older brother?
It's not just this family, but whichever mafia family that the law enforcement agencies would be dealing with, whether it is Amar Naik, Ashwin Naik, or whether it is Arun Gavli, whether it's Chota Rajan, you will see that the taint of the elder brother or the patriarch gets rubbed off on the younger ones as well. For example, if Chota Rajan is now the gangster in jail, people would also be looking at his brothers in a very questioning way. Similarly, even Arun Gavli, they were looking at Arun Gavli, they were also looking at Asha Gavli and her bank accounts. So what I'm saying is the family cannot escape the glare and the scrutiny of the law enforcement agencies by saying that we are not involved or we are innocent. Because Dawood became biggest, most notorious and had more infamy to his name than other dons, naturally the cops are going to look for reasons to see if his family member are in some way connected with him, or they can get more clues and more background on him.
What were the dynamics like? Was there any resentment that any of the family members felt?
In Dawood's clan, I found that whatever may happen, they always held Dawood in high esteem. And actually Haseena was so much in love with her brother. So I don't think there was any resentment or any kind of complaint that they had against their big brother.
All right.
Yeah. In fact, they were proud. I mean, I know some of his nephews, they used to go and say, "Main Dawood ka bhanja hoon, Dawood mera mama hai." So, I mean, there was so much of pride in that claim that I don't think there'll be any resentment at all.
So, sir, given the fact that Iqbal Kasker's latest arrest, after his arrest, he has in fact told the authorities again that Dawood is in Karachi. Do you think this strengthens the case of the Indian government or the police to bring him back?
Yeah, I don't know about the details of that extortion case against Iqbal Kasker, but I can tell you this, that it is not the first time that Iqbal or anyone has told the Indian agencies that Dawood is in Karachi. Indian government is well aware where Dawood lives in Karachi. They are also aware that he has properties in Lahore, Islamabad and all those places. So what I'm saying is that they are absolutely aware about Dawood's business interests, his properties, his residence and all those details in Pakistan.